Hi everyone, my name is Yi Chun. I'm from Professor Jason Kim's lab, and I'm in my final year of PhD. I'm today sharing my recent publication of suppressing recombination loss in perovskite solar cell with PWSS. And today I'm introducing also our system, which is the Raman system, which is very useful and powerful to capture the doping level of organic materials. For the covering about in three parts of this paper. The first is how we control and change the doping level of PWSS. The second is about how the PWSS change the solar cell behavior. And the very last is about how we confirm it's coming from the recombination changes in the solar cell. For the first part, let's talk about the doping level. As we know that the PWSS is actually a combination of both PDOT and PSS in the matrix, and the PSS actually is a very acidic solution environment. So here we try to use the pH control to dedope the interaction between PSS and the PDOT, as you can see in the figure here. Then we confirm with our Raman system to see if there is a change of the vibrational modes, because the vibrational modes are linked to the spring constant of the bounds. So after we dedope it, the alternative double single bounds will have a change to their spring constants, and then the peak position as well as the intensity will change, as you can see in this figure. So by doing so, we can change the doping level of PWSS from 5.1 to all the way 4.6, that's about 500 mEV shift. So then we are ready to put it into our solar cell systems. After we dedope our PWSS, we apply them into our solar cell systems. And here you can see this is our solar simulator and currently under operation with very strong one sunlight at the moment. So for the dedope PWSS perovskite system, their VOC are actually decreased, which means there is a lower voltage output, and also there is a lower power conversion efficiency, means the conversion of the sunlight power into the electric power is getting less and less efficient. We try to check the conductivity of the PWSS after dedoping. We notice there is a significant drop of the doping level as well as the conductivity. And low conductivity is not very nice for the charge extraction. As you can imagine, with the same thickness but lower conductivity, the charges are going to transport with a longer time, which means they're having more chances to meet the counter charges and recombine. So in order to overcome the low charge conductivity, we actually minimize the thickness of our PWSS. We took the most dedoped PWSS and try to dilute it with deionized water. And by doing so, we successfully regained our VOC, as you can see in this chart. And that's very significant improvement to the overall performance. So for the last part, we have to confirm how the interfacial recombination is changed in the system. So here I'm standing in front of our APS system. It has a really sophisticated, complicated system that combines multiple light sources and also combine a very sensitive tip inside. Sorry, I cannot open it because it's actually operating now. So by shining different white lights with the like on and off period, we can check how the charges are generated and redistributed in our solar cell system. By doing so, we see a stronger signal from the dedoped and finished PWSS devices, which means that the charges generated in this condition are having the least recombination loss on the interface, so that the charges can redistribute on the surface and capture by the most sensitive tip from this APS system. Not to mention, we also double confirm with the transient PL to see how fast the charges are decaying. The decay rate of these charges are strongly related to the recombination loss, so that we can confirm that the recombination rate of the DDoF systems are actually lower than the non-DDoF one, the original PWPSS. So, in summary, we successfully managed the doping level of PWPSS, as you can see again from this TOC figure. So, and you can see that by doing the doping level control, actually we get a lower power conversion efficiency due to the low conductivity of the PWPSS. However, we can regain the overall performance when we do, again, the thickness control. Then the overall performance will be much higher than the PCE. And thanks to this glove box, which is the place I fabricate all these perovskite solar cells, and also I'm very happy to work in Jason's group with such a nice facility and funding, and we're looking forward to talk about other more interesting science in the future. Thank you for watching.